Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we will actually do a quick overview of the architecture which we are going to build. So till now we haven't done much. We just created the baseline of the front-end application. Okay, we started creating the layouts of the components. Now we will create a Swiggy landing page and then Swiggy sign up and the login mechanism and then the restaurant page and all the different navigations we are going to add, right? So as we already discussed, there are different possibilities, right? We already have discussed all the entities and the use case and the features, but I will just give a quick overview like what all we are planning to build. Okay, so this can be our API gateway. Okay, now what we have is our Nginx, because we have already all this set up on the local. And to set up all these things on the local, you might be using the Docker containers, because here we are not running only a single microservice, right? So Nginx will actually, on a particular route, will talk to the API gateway, and on a particular route, it will actually render the React.js application for us. So here is our React.js application. On the forward slash, let's say I'm rendering the React.js. On the API route, I am talking to the GraphQL API gateway. So this is the new enhancement. Like in my previous set of applications, I'm not using this GraphQL API gateway. Now I want to explore this thing, and this GraphQL API gateway is going to talk to the multiple Node.js microservices. Okay, so let's say we'll create the containers. Let's say this is the first container, which will manage the authentication service, right? And then we can decide, okay, how we want to achieve this. Are we going to talk to Firebase? Are we going to talk to Auth0 and all these things? Because that decision has not been taken. Here I will just talk about Auth0, because in one of my application I'm already using Firebase, so I want to give a little different try. Maybe I will choose Auth0 here for providing the login, but Auth0 doesn't provide, I think, custom login screen. So we'll just see this on this decision what we need to do. Then we decided a lot of different microservices we are going to write, right? So the concept, I mean, I'm not talking about the different microservices we are going to have. There will be many. Okay, I will just draw them. And then we have like a database, MySQL. We are going to use Postgres here. I don't see a Postgres logo, so I'm putting the MySQL. Okay, this is the kind of architecture, right? Now, why we need this GraphQL API gateway? So this GraphQL API gateway will expose the query and mutations. I mean, this is a GraphQL, not a REST interface, but this GraphQL interface will talk to these services. So this will talk to these services, and it can be like it can act like a REST aggregator, which will aggregate the response coming from all these microservices and will give a response to the client in form of query and mutation. Mutations like when you are creating, updating the resources, query when you are just reading the data about the restaurant, reading the data about the user, his orders, or tracking and all these things. Okay. So this is pretty much simple we are going to have, and we also going to have a Redis for the caching of the resources. That is must to have, because we can't design it without that system. We want to have our APIs performing very well, right? We can also cache the user data using auth service. We can cache the restaurant information. We can cache a lot of different things, right? So it can be a single container. You just provide a different namespace or different prefix for the query, prefix for the Redis keys, and you can manage it like that. Okay, so this Auth0 either will be talking to the Auth0 for the login and the sign up, because what happens in Auth0, we onboard the user and then give a credential to the user, and user can actually do the login. So we may either write our own authentication system, which is a login sign up, reset password, forget password, or we can use the Firebase. Firebase is very good in this particular case. And we are heavily going to use the mobile number for the resetting the password or the logging, user login and all. Right, and at the end, we have our user. who is going to use this application from outside. We will just expose the front end interface. Okay, so this is combining everything together. This is how our application look like. I mean, I'm just exploring the options of the GraphQL API gateway. So GraphQL giving these kind of options, which is nothing but aggregating the response coming from the different REST APIs and exposing the whole overall schema from this particular service. So all our services will be hidden after this API gateway. They will not be directly exposed. They may be running on the different host or different container or different port. Okay, this GraphQL API gateway will just talk to them. We are not managing this the service registry and service discovery mechanism, right? I mean, that will be too much on the local system because we may think of deploying it somewhere. Okay, so the first thing first, now our next target is to actually create the front end UI components first and then start moving towards the services. Okay, so that is our next target and we'll start working on it.